We've got FGS JV versus PBE Boss. Make some noise!
Dream of Destiny.
Playbook has drawn a first blood.
Dream of Destiny. Rainbow Mika. Guile.
Come on!
Yo! Mika wins.
Mika wins.
of destiny. Rainbow Mika. Dawson. This is the pop to keep life. Round one. Fight. They call it to you. Round one. Fight. Round one. Fight!
Fight! Mic test, mic test. Mic test. Mic test, mic test.
This is the fourth mic test.
All right, I hear you.
All right, last time the match we saw before was Ibuki, so that was a match that we rarely see because there are rarely any Ibuki players here.
Not a lot of people brave enough to really try out the DLC characters just yet.
Yeah, because the thing with Ibuki is she's kind of a sleeper character that we don't know what she has to offer. But we've seen a few people kind of like
also, to add to the fact that she's a different character from what we saw her.
Oh yes, in her.
What we saw of her in the Street Fighter 4.
Oh yes, which is for Vortex Heavy, pretty much the Armika of Street Fighter 4, if you would say.
Basically, and just let that simmer. Probably give it a few more events. We'll see more Ibuki showing up. I got a couple of friends who would also like to see what she can do.
All right, so for our next match, we have FGS versus PB Eric. All right, he has made some few character switches in the past. He's actually used Ken before, and now I think he's made his stick to Birdie. But I'm sure that Eric is no stranger to the Birdie match because, of course, he has Ozzy and Kabir, and we have also Ace and Bully, of course, from PB.
Of course, whenever Bully's here, he gets into a lot of games with Eric.
Oh yeah.
So there's no shortage on practice against Birdie, and that is definitely showing right here.
He's really familiar with the matchup. Nice zoning, but it's actually unsafe.
V trigger is active. That damage output is going to be insane. But you gotta get. He needs to get in. Needs to make use of that.
Oh yes.
Slowly counting down.
And you got to be patient as well. Oh, nice buff by Julio. Come to set up after. Nice empty jump again. Very nice overhead by Eric.
Round two. Fight.
Eric is actually one of the most fundamentally strong players I've seen because back in Street Fighter 4, he was actually using a board. And I'm glad to see how he's transitioned back to Street Fighter 5 with his character. Oh, nice perfect! This is gonna be a perfect.
Are we going to see a perfect? Oh, nope, no. Not quite.
But Eric has 4 meter.
Sitting on a critical art, will he end this with a statement? What I did notice about Eric from the earlier matches is that, yes, he is, from the last time I saw him fight, actually gotten a lot better.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
If you ask me, it's like probably just about a week since I last saw him, and somehow, I don't know where he went or which mountains he went up to, but there's something a bit different about what I'm seeing tonight.
I think something snapped in him that told him, this is it. This is the something that will help me get better. So I think this is Chad versus Eric. It's going to be a mirror match, probably, between two Ryus. Chad is actually one of the resident Ryu players in Fairview. So let's see. It's going to be a battle between the Ryus. So Chad is in the vanilla Ryu, while Eric is in the blue Ryu. And actually,
North versus South. Who gets to take home that lovely belt?
Let's see. So the score is now 4-4.
Fight! Hadouken!
Nice bait. Didn't capitalize. Nice punish there.
Eric finally retaliating.
Didn't capitalize on the last punish.
Nice throw.
Oh, nice!
Air EX Tatsu.
Tried to bait out the DP. Nice, goes to the fireball with the Tatsu. Nice punish there. This is the beer version to take out the stun. I thought it was going to go for a cross level.
Back throw from Eric. Eric pretty close to closing out the round. Gets into the sweep.
He's just showing how better he is as a Ryu player.
Round two.
But to also add to that, not here with us is FGS Jobe. He's actually one of the Super Diamond players of Fairview. Nice tech there. If you notice, Ryu's jump light kick is really, really hard to land here. Nice wake up, PP.
Nice throw, Barrick. There's a beam reverse here. Both fighters keep the pressure on each other. Very close, by the way, in terms of remaining life.
But then again, Eric has the round lead. Nice anti-air by Chad. Nice confirm there. Nice jump in. It's gonna be
a little more. Could be anywhere.
Nice anti-air by Eric.
Eric gets it.
You win.
So who's up next? Okay, we have Xenon Lex. Who's actually our current player. We actually use Lars and Xiaoyu back in Tekken. And now he's making his transition back in Street Fighter V. So let's see what he can do.
Player 2 has a 5-win streak.
Round 1. Fight!
Alright, who do we have remaining on the Playbook Elite side and the FGS sides, respectively?
So I think we have Mitsu. For FGS, I think we have Mitsu. We have, let's see. We have Mitsu. We have Jermaine. Let's see. I'm not sure. Xenon Lex is rolling out in a bikini costume. So how about this matchup? What do you think about this?
I haven't fought a lot of Karens.
Round one.
As
fight.
Nash, but every time I'm on the receiving end of it, I will definitely say that she's one of the scarier characters in SF5, especially in the hands of someone who knows how to use her.
Oh yeah. Actually, you've seen those like in the likes of Zambi and BB Justin.
Yeah. Justin is a good example. The pressure that she can put on is monstrous at times.
But let's see if Xenon Lex can apply this pressure to Eric. But I think he's a well person in this matchup. Nice spear reversal. Take what you can get. Nice spear reversal to remove the pressure. The thing about Eric is he actually anti-airs very rarely. So he really discards the jump out. Oh!
Xenon with the critical art.
Didn't even get the punish there. What happened?
But he closes out the round anyway.
But that could have been. That could have turned south for him.
That would have been a monumental punish.
Goes for the fireball with that. Nice pick up DP.
We're seeing some nice really good spacing from Eric here.
Oh yeah. That's the thing that he's played with the Elite player. He has really, really good fundamentals. Beware, Eric has the full meter.
EX Tatsu, EX Fireball.
KO.
Nice. Excellent job from Eric. So up next we have FGS Jermaine.
You wins.
We got Eric slowly bowing down.
Could this be an OCV for him? So let's see. Let's see. The thing with Jermaine is he actually has two characters in his arsenal. He has a Chun-Li and he has a Pocket Jury.
One will we see tonight?
Let's see. But definitely I think he's more comfortable with his Chun-Li because he actually put PBE Dawn to the limit in the last tournament. It actually went 2-1 with him.
Nice.
So let's see what he can do now.
Or will he try to... Well, there's Chun-Li. I was about to say, will he try to psych Eric out by using Jury?
Never mind, let's see.
Going with a tried and tested Chun-Li here.
It's actually one of the most fearsome Chun Li's I've seen, along with IPT Drew.
Are we gonna see instant air legs all night?
Round one. Fight!
Alright, here we go. The thing is, some Chun Li's use the instant air legs to delay their jump arc. Nice plus under. Oh, nice! Didn't get the full combo though. Alright, jumps on the fireball.
An exchange of projectiles. Eric is still in the lead.
Nice reset there. Nice, DP's out of that. Use the EX fireball to get the knockdown.
Eric pops B trigger.
Nice anti-air there.
That has got to earn, of course, extra damage and stun. Closing the round out with a B trigger fireball.
It's looking really, really bad for Team FGS right now.
Fight.
Oh, this is the parry.
I am genuinely surprised at this level of performance that we're seeing from Eric tonight.
Yeah, it's actually really different from what you've seen, what we've used to see, right?
What I've seen, and I've already seen a couple of events with him present. I've even fought him once. He wasn't like this the last time I fought him.
He's playing like a man possessed right now. Nice anti-air legs. Almost went for the shimmy there from Jermaine. Was it a little bit too late?
We are definitely going to ask him about what he's been doing for practice.
Well, I think last night they were having some late night casuals with the Cavite players, so I think that's going off right now.
That, whatever they did in those casuals, they're helping right now.
Oh, yes. Actually, one factor is that Paper Trail actually used Nekari for that night. And I think it helped with maybe Eric's matchup against James.
Of course, James being one of the most dangerous Nekalis out there.
Along with Yoshi 99 and 5.
Guys, if you haven't seen that match from Esports Festival just this past weekend at ABCC, we suggest you find it.
It's really, really scary.
It was crazy, right?
Nice punish there.
Nice throw tech. You got a back throw. Instant air legs once again. And crouching medium punch. Trying to get in.
The thing is, Charlie has a meter advantage right now. Just a little more. You have the advantage. He's trying to burn out the V meter. Oh no, didn't go for the super.
V reversal from Eric. Those matches remain. V reversal once again. Jermaine sitting on a full critical meter. Well, two bars now. And Locke's taken down.
So Jermaine finally ends Eric's streak.
Chun-Li wins.
Eric's reign of terror just ending right there with Jermaine. Pretty solid match. So, sitting in for PBE.
We have Cha from Cavite as well. Actually, a bison.
Chun-Li.
Be good, bison.
Let's see what Cha can do in this matchup against Jermaine. I think with Bison, he has a lot of scary moves. He's actually one of the characters that has really high damage off crush counter.
I love Bison's crush counters and what you can get off of them.
Oh yeah.
Now the other cool thing about Bison is he has ridiculously slow walk speed. The slowest in the game, if I'm not mistaken.
He's actually literally walking, right?
Yes. And what he does to make up for it is the kind of range that he gets on his moves.
Oh yes, yes.
His moves will take him from one place to another. That makes up for his lack in the default mobility.
Yeah, actually his down forward hard punch could actually cover about half screen.
Well, it's pretty far reaching. Deceptively so. I think the hitbox on that is way longer than it's supposed to. Or way longer than it looks.
Oh no, then again, it's capitalized with that.
Trying to get the cross up back there. EX Devil's reverse.
And also, a lot of Bison will be a plus. It's actually worse than the party bumper.
Just still trying to find a way in.
But the really good levels of Chun-Li is making this very, very difficult.
Here we go. Nice little combo from Chat. Trade right there.
Nice.
And oh, this has been caught. Drop the combo. EX stop.
Just getting in there.
Those little jabs to keep her out.
And just uses the jab. That was a scramble situation for both players.
Tension was pretty high in that one.
A lot of missed winning out. A lot of missed opportunities for both players there. Nice tech there.
Air throw from Mermaid. Another throw. We have the stun. Mermaid goes in for the combo, drops it. And out goes Chop.
Chun-Li wins.
Who do we have up next?
Oh, so we have Zambi, one of the resident current players also with Playbook. I believe he's actually in Platinum ranks right now, if I'm not mistaken, online.
Now, I don't get to play a lot online. You can chalk that up to a pretty bad internet connection, but hopefully before the year, I can fix that.
Oh, yeah.
Online is basically the core of Street Fighter V now.
Yeah, because the arcade that was like, is actually gone.
Yeah.
As comparison to back in the core of Street Fighter 4, where Japan actually had arcades, they had IC cards.
Definitely. And as far as I know, what's the minimum? Okay, let's be a little technical here. What's the minimum connection speed that you would probably recommend to someone who wants to play Street Fighter V online?
For me, I think 3 Mbps connection would do, but in some cases, my personal connection is about 8 to 10 Mbps, but sometimes it still wouldn't cut it, even in local full game connections. But when fighting against international players, it actually does well.
I think it's more of an issue when fighting local players.
Oh, yeah.
Because if you're going to look at the Facebook groups, yes, it's a lot of people complaining about how it's hard to interconnect between ISPs here, but finding foreign opponents is actually pretty easy.
Oh yeah, and yeah, just speaking about that, really, really good performance by Zambi.
That was pretty commanding. We were just talking here, the round's pretty much over.
Oh yeah, the thing is, actually, FGS has their own resident Karin player, Bin Choi, but unfortunately, he's not here with us. He should give some advice in this matchup.
Color me pleasantly surprised. I didn't know PBE was busting out two pirates for tonight. But here we are.
Really scary performance by Zambi. Nice empty jump. Didn't capitalize on that.
Alright, here we go. It's a missile combo. The main falls out of it.
And here we go with a critical arc.
Ends it really fast. And we're gonna see a laugh.
Probably one of the fastest games we've seen for tonight.
It's actually really scary when Kermit gets in your face, like you were saying, right? It's really, really scary.
The pressure and the mix-ups, especially in the hands of someone who knows exactly what to do, because you can mash that V-trigger Gurenken all day, but if you don't really know how to time it or use it properly, then all that's gonna be lost.
Come on.
Especially against someone who's pretty defensive.
Karin
playing Zamius, he's used it to his full extent. And actually, one of the scariest tools of Karin is actually her standing light kick. It's actually +2 or +3, if I'm not mistaken. So he could actually go into a throw after or go for another counter hit setup.
Round one. Fight!
Traditionally, this matchup, I think, is in Karin's favor because she has a good rush down. But the thing with JR is, he's actually one of these fundamentally strong Guile players back in Lotus Street Fighter 4. For a while, I thought that was cross up.
Having a full meter is more dangerous than seeing them actually use it.
Yes, because you're sometimes hesitant of actually doing your meaties because it's... Right, is it gonna turn it? Chooses not to.
Not quite yet.
He's using the fear of the V-trigger. Goes to stun the
EX for Senha. Here comes the stun, and we are going into V-Trigger to finish off the round.
So it will only take one more character, one more guy for Team FGS. So the last man standing is FGS Mitsu. So it's going to be a Dawson versus Karin. This matchup is going to be very, very hard for Dawson. Really, really nice performance. It's gonna be Karin versus Guile.
Karin
versus Dawson, I'm sorry.
This is your path to achieve life.
I remember talking to Zambi about this matchup. I actually heard that he's really confident about this, especially with his experience online. Let's see if he can make use of that right now.
Round one. Fight!
Nice, trade on the V-skill.
Clearly, Mitsu is trying to keep his distance, but that's not quite working against Zabby. Zabby trying to keep it close.
It's actually all lying on Zabby right now. The hope of Team FGS taking game one is all on him. Alright, nice meaties.
Flame Carpet's out. Carrot's out of it too.
But beware, Dolls in Maskable Meter. Using the fire to cover his approach. Nice jump in! Perfect spacing there.
You gotta appreciate the timing of players who can jump in past Dalsim's Yoga Fire here in SF5.
It's actually really hard to do that. Plus,
that arc is not easy to get past. We have a stun for Mitsu.
Oh! Let's see if he can make a comeback.
A little bit of silence right there between these two.
KO.
And a little jab to close out the round.
But here's the thing, he has the full meter.
Final round.
It's gonna be very scary for Dalsim.
Fight!
Crush counter. Not much of a follow-up from that. Mitsu seemingly playing a little more aggressively this round.
Kind of like Bombi, if you would say.
Yep. Of course, Bombi known for his super aggressive Dalsim.
Whoa! Reset again!
Are we gonna see it? EX Reset Hug, he's going for the stun. Definitely going for it.
And here we go!
Here we go!
So Team Playbook takes game number one. It's up now 1-0 for Team Playbook.
Kari wins.
This is a best of three series, is it right? Is that right?
Yes. So here's the thing. If both teams go 1-1, it's gonna be down to a captain's match. It's gonna be between FGS boss and PBE boss.
Nice.
So yeah, just gonna give some shoutouts to our sponsors, Red Bull, and yes, actually now Playbook's partners with Twitch, as I've heard.
Which is a pretty sweet deal. We've also got topology.ph.
Yes, of course.
And Circuit Makati. For those of you who want to tune in, tell your friends to head on over to twitch.tv/playbook_ph.
Yes, we've got another game up. So it's going to be the classic again. It's going to start out with the two team captains.
The boss battle.
Yes, quite literally the boss battle.
As we'd like to call it. Are we seeing Balrog versus Guile?
But the thing is, Jamie also has a Nekali as a pocket.
I've seen his Nekali in action. But not enough of it to really make a fair judgment call on it.
Oh, wait, let's see. Is it
and it Nekali is a Nekali-Guile matchup.
Guile.
Boss going the costumes. Air Force One, here we go.
So what's going to win out? Is it pure savagery versus the power of freedom?
Round one.
Here we go. Traditionally, this matchup is in favor of Nekali because he has a great rushdown tool. But let's see if Boss can make an adjustment to this. Alright, Boss is now making the aggression as opposed to the traditional matchup.
Of course, PBE Boss. A pretty proficient Guile player.
He's actually a Guile loyalist ever since Street Fighter 4.
I only ever saw him temporarily move on over to Nash before Guile came out.
Oh yeah. He actually had a game for a while. Alright, here we go. The thing with Boss is I think Nekali is actually working out better for him. But nonetheless, PB a Boss Richard takes a round.
Round two. Fight.
Right, nice neutral from the two. Alright, does it wake up TP?
Nice EX on move right there.
Right, nice BTs by Boss. almost goes to stun. Goes into V-trigger Super Saiyan mode.
And that color scheme is really popping against this stage that we have right now.
Oh, yes.
Here comes the flurry of Sonic Boobs.
Oh, nice! Boss uses the EX to get rid of the V-skill. Alright, so we have CFX up next. It's gonna be Karin versus Guile. So let's see what's up next. Oh wait, I'm actually having some malfunctions right now. Let's see.
Technical problems.
Alright, there we go.
Round one.
We're all good. Let's see.
Fight!
Okay, we good to go? Alright, going back to character and stage select. We are seeing a Karin versus Guile.
In the last game, we've actually seen how Zambi dominated that matchup. But let's see if Xenolex can transition and make the same statement as Zambi did against Team Playbook.
Karin contra Guile.
Come on!
Right, here we go. Let's see if Boss can make a comeback with this.
Round
right, here
one.
We go. We're in the beach stage in Zuko Resort. Interestingly, in Evo, this stage was banned because of, I think, Birdie's ban.
A lot of low-profile moves would be obscured by the water.
Yes. Kind of like Brady's can as well, and his bananas.
In some cases, some examples have been posted on Twitter, even Chun-Li's crouching media punch would be obscured. Because of course, she just goes flies directly on the ground while sliding forward. It's extremely hard to see.
Oh, no punish there, my boss.
Nice beam reversal.
Nice return there. Nice wake up.
EX for Senha from Xenon Lux.
Oh, intro stand.
Both fighters on the verge of taking this round. Who is going to flinch? PB Boss with the flurry of Sonic Boost and the jab.
He didn't even need to block it. Just used the jab to interrupt it.
Nice move. Round two.
The thing is, Boss used all of his meter in that last round. Nice air throw. Really good priority on that.
Making a statement with that air throw. I'm also noticing that when PBE Boss throws out a jab, he's pretty committed to it.
Oh, yes.
More or less knowing that, yes, this is a good time to jab.
And I'm sure he's actually played some sets with PBE Justin to see. Sonic
Boom. Nice air throw once again. PBE Boss on the verge.
Nice overhead. So Boss takes it 2-0 up against Team FGS.
Guile wins.
So it's going to be probably Guile versus Ryu up next.
Player 2 has a 5-win streak.
I'm sure Chad is well versed in this matchup because he has FGS JR on his side. Was actually a Guile player, as we've seen earlier.
The question is, will be enough against this particular Guile?
Oh yes, let's see.
Dream of Destiny. Ryu.
As we've said a ton of times before,
Guile.
Street Fighter V, you may be playing the same character as some other guy, but The way that this game is built feels like it's just really expressive in terms of playstyles.
Yes, you get to show who you are by playing your character.
And what's even cooler about this, there's no, I guess, past fighting games, like, let's say CBSU would have a style select or something called group select that determines what you can do. Here, there's none of that. You just have your tools, and it's just really, it really just boils down to how you play.
Yeah, speaking of CBS, you remember the bad days of A Group Visor.
Yeah, definitely.
Right, nice DP there from Shad. All right, interrupts there. Nice. Just circling Chad right now. Like I said, very difficult to anti-air Ryu.
PBU boss trying to cover his approach. I smell a bit of a scramble coming.
Right, now he puts himself in the corner.
Both players fishing for hits.
If Boss gets this, it's going to be a huge upset.
There you go.
Right, Chad getting the first round of this
round
game.
Two. Fight.
Right. Now, Chad has lost in the corner.
PB boss whipping Chad with a sweep right there.
Alright, nice bag there. But nonetheless, he gets hit out.
Pretty smart of PB boss to cover his approach all the time.
Never go in without a fireball. Boss is taking this. Let's go from Chad.
Music active, nice flash kick right there.
Can Boss make this comeback?
There you go.
But the fireballs from the EX gets through.
Nonetheless, that was a pretty good run.
Ryu wins.
From PBE Boss. Up next,
we have Chat. So it's going to be Ryu versus Bison.
Now what I would love to see are more of those really sweet Bison crush counters.
Oh yeah, like after a whiff DP, it's really weird to see how you see those crush counters.
Dream of Destiny.
It's a matter of getting that good but making it all count. Happen right now.
Round one. Fight.
Thing with Bison is really
first time I've seen that V skill used tonight.
It's really, really hard to anti air with Bison. As he has really subpar normals. Nice conversion out of that.
Crush counter sweep, pops a V trigger. Alright, more boom properties. Of course, more Bison's boom properties get changed whenever he pops V trigger.
Round two. Fight.
Chad taking that first round. What's up, Justin? Yeah, so Paulus, just in case that Bison needs to be replaced in Paulus and Fred. So what's going on? What's going on? So far, Chad with a life lead. Nice throw. Right. Nice anti-air from Chad.
Spear reversal.
There you go.
Okay. The first bite.
There you go. Dangerous character.
That is a perfect teleport from the air.
A ridiculously sweet devil's reverse.
I didn't expect that. But that was beautifully done.
Alright, genuinely surprising right there. Okay, so again, traveling the zoning gate here. Went for the shimmy there.
Rotate.
Oh, no anti-air there from Ryu. Oh, nice, got Ryu in the corner. Oh, is that nice.
Chao's basically going, no, you get back in the corner.
Oh, no. Don't confirm there, too far for the combo to connect. Oh, again, no anti-air there from Chao. Like, he's waiting for the ground game.
Here comes the V-Trigger once again. Of course, Bison becoming a much scarier character, but V-Trigger is active. Psycho Inferno and Psycho Blast. Chao picking up a win for Team Playbook Elite.
Good job, Chao. Good job.
This is the 13th win.
All right, so it's going to be Jermaine. I've just Jermaine's Chun-Li.
For you, the day that Chad defeated you in the Dominion team battle was the most important day of your life, but the Chad was Friday. Yeah, but pulling quotes for
that was a pretty good use of
the 1994 from Street Fighter movie again.
All right, so FGS, I am going to play. Defense on Chad. Defense on Chad.
I am fighting.
Oh, it's gonna be Jason's Ibuki from FGS. So yeah, Jason is one of the Ong brothers together with JV and JR from Fairview. So we're glad to have him here. But now back to the match. This is gonna be again Ibuki versus Bison.
Something we don't see a lot yet.
Yeah, I haven't actually played an Ibuki online
against. I guess with concerns to the DLC characters, especially the newer ones, you won't see them that much in competitive play just yet.
Yeah.
Give them some time to simmer.
I'm not sure it's because before the DLC characters came out, probably some of the players have become loyal to their previous characters. But I've known a couple of players who played Ibuki since Street Fighter 4. She's a little bit very technical character, so.
And of course, she's been changed up quite a lot here in SF5.
Yeah.
But
I
still,
mean,
very entertaining to watch.
I didn't know where the bomb came from.
Round two. Fight.
Oh, nice setup. Did you see that?
Jason with the target combos.
Has also a yellow side to him.
He gets the stun, looking to close out the round.
Oh, nice.
Ibuki wins.
Alright, so Paolo looking to redeem himself. But like I said, barely no one knows the Ibuki matchup, so even I can't explain what just happened there, but apparently she also has a lot of mix-up tools. That was very vague, actually.
Okay, some moves from SF4 taken out,
so
some
at
new
this
ones
point,
added in, of course.
Yeah, so at this point, Paolo, as we know, has many characters, but he's maining Nekazi. But you never know what he's going to use against
Vega.
Like I said, his main is Nekali, but suddenly he's switching to Vega.
How many characters does he actually have?
I'm pretty sure he used
not the whole cast.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, he started off with as Vega when Street Fighter 4 first came out, but actually after about
round
1 week or 2 weeks, he then became Zangief, and then he became Nekali. But this was his actual original character for Street Fighter 4.
Kala going flawless.
Forcing
it faster door in flawless mode. As Vega goes with a meter
there. They should go event for the ground. Alright, nice combo there from Paolo. Finish it off.
Round two. Fight.
Impressive showing there. A lot more solid than in the previous game.
Again, Vega, one of the very rare characters that they're being used here in Street Fighter V. So we only know one Vega. Actually, CJ here from.
Of course, Vega changed up a lot from his classic iteration.
Yeah.
For the longest time, ever since his first appearance, he was a charge character. Now,
yes.
Now
I was actually very surprised. Although there's not, yeah. I didn't think that he's even one special move that's a bit special. So that's charge, I mean.
Now he's all
okay.
He's all motions. Probably giving you a little more leeway, and Paolo takes the round.
Okay, so Paolo takes the round from Kesa.
Vega wins.
Well, you were right. He did redeem himself from earlier.
Yeah. Go on to this bad.
So, who is he up against?
It's
next?
Gonna be Dylan. Okay, all so right. Yeah. Dylan, one of the best Armika players here in the country so far. Along with Krimpai from Playpad.
And I just saw his Mika in action earlier.
Right now, everyone's talking about.
Rainbow took out nearly Mika. Half of Playbook Elite.
I mean, Armika's a very explosive character, so.
Right
to play, right?
Are there, yes, we'll have to get that cleared up. Is there a character lock between, I mean, of course, this isn't a single tournament, it's a team battle, it could be a little different.
Round one.
We'll let
so
the,
we're not really sure about the rules here, but.
We'll let the TOs discuss that among themselves.
Yeah. Yeah, so we're supposed to say if you won,
you get locked into that character.
Yeah. But I guess for this one, you have allowed it.
EX command.
Oh my gosh.
Not quite a...
Oh, there goes some mix up. Oh my god. Did you see that damage?
Here he comes. V-trigger.
Oh,
no follow up.
No follow up. Come on. Oh gosh.
KO.
Oh yeah, sorry. That was a bit nice.
Round two. Fight.
We're seeing basically, yeah, two very explosive characters.
Yeah.
Once they
when these two are fighting, we don't expect the round, you know, to finish up. It's gonna end in like 30 seconds or less, probably.
Once any of these characters gets a drop on you, you are going to see a lot of red just drop off from your health bar.
Nice! Punish.
Okay. Oh, look at it, a little bro.
So go in. What's gonna be set up?
Little relentless.
Okay, yeah. So I think the best way to deal with.
And here comes the critical arch. Is it going to be a kill? Most likely.
Yeah, it's gonna kill.
Still, very impressive showing from Bala.
Good job.
Mika wins.
And here we are again. I believe this is...
Alright. Okay. So... Tux has been looking forward to this match.
It's his first appearance tonight.
Yes.
In tonight's team battle.
Dream of Destiny. Rainbow Mika.
Is he gonna rock Nash? Yep. Nash represent. Yes, because I also
gotta be Nash.
I also play Nash. So okay, this pleases me.
Gosh. So if Tooks wins this all throughout, I still hope that I get a chance to play. I haven't had a showing yet today.
Round one.
But Tooks is determined to finish this off right now. Yeah.
Nice opening from Tooks.
So Tooks has a very good record against Villa. That's a guy that just wanted to play this.
Sweep. And the power bomb.
Okay.
Nice EX
playing the neutral game.
Low pierce.
Oh, nice.
Dylan okay. Trying to get in.
Yeah.
Tooks probably going there for.
This is a very hard match for. I have to say, for Mika. So she's a very explosive character, but her footsies are definitely not good, so...
There's a certain level of patience needed for Mika's footsies, and
she has to wait for that perfect moment to come in.
I believe that most of her damage comes from waiting for opponents to make mistakes.
Yeah.
So far, Tooks hasn't been making a lot.
Yeah.
Crush counter.
Yeah, so Mika's job here is to put Tooks in the corner. So that will put her very much on advantage. But right now, now puts Tooks in the corner, but
fighting his way out. Every time he gets put in the corner, he'll just fight his way out of it. Dylan figuring out how to approach.
Oh my gosh, there you go.
Critical.
The very reliable wake up super.
I know a lot of people.
Oh wow.
A lot of people will
that
rag.
Is perfect.
A lot of people will rag against the wake up super.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know, that's a scrubby thing to do, but if it keeps on working, it keeps on working.
Yes.
And sometimes
it just works, I suppose.
Especially in times when you least expect it. Because you gotta admit, for in situations like these, in tournaments, team battles, you don't expect a wake-up super.
Yeah.
You don't expect the
Back in Street Fighter 4, you can see that very often, but the Street Fighter 5 is actually very unusual. Oh, nice.
Heat trigger stopped right there.
Oh my god.
Here comes the critical art. Gotta do a lot of damage,
yeah,
not
it's
going
gonna
to
be,
kill
it's gonna, she's gonna be alive. And she has a lot of meter, so.
She is sitting on full resources.
Oh!
Mika wins.
FGS Dylan's Mika wreaking havoc once again. Solid showing from Tooks, though.
Yeah, yeah. That was a perfect time to have meter, though.
Definitely one of the more exciting matches of the night.
Yeah.
So totally yeah, we did not expect that to happen.
Okay, so this is going to be a match between two grapplers. Okay, so I haven't seen this matchup before, but I think the two have been playing earlier at casuals. Yeah. So not very sure, but I'm sure Jaman has definitely some experience already with this one. Let's see how it's gonna.
Round one. Fight.
Okay, so I think they're going for the button check here. Okay, so yeah, Jaman here, one of our bad players. One of the very few bad players here in this game.
But with that, still has a pretty terrifying Alex from what I've seen of
him. Yeah.
Dream of Destiny. Rainbow Mika. Alex. This is the perfect for warm-up.
Of course,
Dylan's gotta aim for all those mix-ups and resets in the corner.
Yeah, yeah.
Most likely Paper Trail. Just really gotta aim for crush counters and all those solid hits.
So fast though.
Like we said, crush counter to a stomp. And a power bomb.
The stun on that, so much damage. Oh!
All that damage.
Alright, let's see what this attack is gonna be.
Whoa! Uses the V reversal to get out of the Deshiko's
way. Oh my gosh. Oh no, please.
Here comes the mix-up once again. And just I was about to say that.
That is so quick. I mean, you have to be really fast to react to something like that. So. And it goes almost. You see the distance in battle.
Yep. Power bomb. Crush counter. Static medium. That's a EX chop.
That's a 50-50. Okay, so what's going for the reset there?
The reversal.
Okay. Command grab. Jaman is pretty much this. But he's in the corner, so let's see how he's gonna react.
Paper Trail always going for the crush counters. He needs just one to make this count. V reversal.
What?
EXP
that
just
is
missing.
So
no! And nice. Nice neutral jump roundhouse. Paper Trail Alex taking win. Out Dylan. That was a shorter run from Dylan than what we saw earlier.
Yeah, yeah.
I guess they figured
that's a pretty even matchup though for the two. But this time, I guess he made the wrong guesses. So for the every time that crush counter
I saw,
hit him, yeah.
I think this is the match where I saw the most crush counters because every 3 seconds we see a crush.
That's definitely the most powerful move of Alex. Because the opponent blocks, that crush counter it's +3 for Alex. So sometimes it's better to just some people think it's just better to be grabbed.
Round one.
Not to be crush countered, but I guess all those guesses were wrong for Dylan. But now back to the match. It's going to be an Alex versus a Kyle. See the distance at which he jumps? It's a perfect distance. It makes full length of that high kick. That's very ambiguous for Kyle to do an kick, yeah. An anti-air kick.
Style with a life lead. Main problem against Guile is just figuring out how to get in. Here comes the power bomb.
Yeah. See, yeah. So he's waiting for that. Actually, went for an air grab there. Yep. Against a
brush counter.
Oh! Against a character like Guile, I guess it's just one of the few ways that Alex can come in. You know, for it's so hard for characters like Everett that they use. Because the recovery also in the Sonic Boom is so fast.
Yeah. By the time he's done throwing out one Sonic Boom, he has another prepped and ready to go.
And he has a V-skill that, you know, sometimes tends the other player to jump in, thinking it's a projectile, but it's not.
Basically, the animation can fool you into thinking it's a Sonic.
Yes.
See? Right there.
So already has a...
There's a bit of psychological warfare going on here. There's a slight difference in the animation, but when everything's happening this fast, you're gonna think it is a Sonic Boom animation.
Oh, there we go. There's so much armor in that.
Alright, who's up next? Alright, looks like we got Bombi.
Okay,
sitting in
gonna
for
be
PBE.
This is the 11th win for player one.
Yeah. So round if this one is gonna be a Guile versus Dalsim,
fight!
This time it's going to be oh no. This time it's going to be a Dalsim. Dalsim is gonna be at advantage here definitely. It's gonna be a hard match for a Guile.
And of course, Bombi notorious. I think that's the word we're looking for here. Notorious for his ridiculously aggressive Dalsim.
Yeah. So his Dalsim, as compared to, let's say, FGS's Mitsu's Dalsim, is quite different.
Not quite, the pacifist.
Yeah. It has its, definitely has advantages. And I saw them playing early at Casuals, a Dalsim mirror match. It's quite interesting.
Dalsim.
Okay. I would actually think, yeah, this is a better matchup. Yeah. So, yeah. Actually, before JR started off as Guile, his main character. Well, actually, his main character was Nash, but he switched very early to Lara. But when Guile came out, boom.
And he's been rocking Guile ever since?
Yes. That was his character ever since Street Fighter 4, so that was very much expected of JR, but I'm not sure how often he's been playing Lara. But this evens up the match a little bit more. Lara also has very ambiguous setups. There you go. So when you block it. Oh my god! Yeah. So that kick has a very high priority. So even though actually that was an anti-air from Dalsim, that was enough damage to win the round for JR's Lara.
And that was a ridiculously fast round, something that you do not normally say when Dalsim is involved, but both.
Yeah, I mean, we know Dalsim before, as you know. Only now is Street Fighter V has become more, also an offensive character, but he's always been a zoner since the old Street Fighter 4 days. So
slow, steady, and patient.
Yeah. Alright, so Bombi.
Basically, I would say that Dalsim in Street Fighter V is now the equivalent of Gandhi in the Civilization series. He played Civilization. Gandhi
is this a Civilization, a piece of game in Civilization?
Yes. Gandhi in Civilization is notorious for basically, of course, we know him as the historical figure, but in Civilization, he likes to nuke people.
Right. I agree.
He is aggressive and will just launch nukes at you all day long. While, of course, real life
actually,
Gandhi was a pacifist.
Yeah. The only Civilization I played was the latest one, Civ 5. But I think they're coming up with Civ 6, right?
It's coming up. And of course, it was just recently announced that yes, Gandhi is coming back. I don't think it would be a Civilization game without Gandhi.
I think he's always been there. Right?
Of course.
There we go, nice damage.
Bombi taking care of business. Solid showing right there.
Alright.
Solid showing from
nice
both
mix up
players.
There from
Dalsim.
From Bombi. Okay, so I think Huya's coming up. Okay, so this is gonna be a Dalsim versus. Yeah. Dalsim versus Birdie. And this one is going to be. If Julio sticks with Birdie, this is going to be a very uphill battle.
Oh, what's the wow. Okay, I didn't expect that.
I haven't seen Julio play Ryu for a while, but. Zambi. Yeah! Oy! Wala na pala din naglalaro sa atin.
Round 1.
After na lang.
Fight!
Of course, Dalsim benefiting from the added mobility of his free skill.
What can I say? Bobby knows this matchup very much. He's played with Dawn a couple of times. I remember on DB Dawn, so he knows this matchup very well. Let's see how he's gonna play this one.
Yeah. Round 2. Fight!
Well, I'm seeing the amount of focus on Bumpy's face right now. I'm not sure he's... At the rate he's going, I'm not sure he's gonna let you play, man.
Yeah, I mean, he's determined to finish this off. Like, but then again, there's still a couple of players left.
There's still very much a lot of room for upsets here.
I think, we still have... Three players for FGX. Okay, so that ends the game. Bobby takes the match against. Okay.
And we got Super James up next.
But still Mitsu on the line and Jermaine, I believe. After this. So, okay.
So we are pretty much down to
After
FGS's this, last three.
Oh, Audi hasn't played. I haven't played. Eric hasn't played yet. And Sammy hasn't played yet from
Nick.
Nikali Dalsim matchup. Of course, James known for his super aggressive playstyle.
It's very difficult for a Dalsim player to
fight
to keep Nikali out.
Yeah, to keep Nikali, especially with. Remember that when Nikali does his claw attack, it has one hit armor, so
it negates projectiles basically.
Yeah. So that's Bobby cannot knows this, so he just kind of
well, he practically can't yoga fire his way out of this.
Yeah,
he's gonna have to be more up close, try to match James at his own game.
There goes the jump in.
Bobby with a teleport, of course, James catching him.
So that was just one jump in from James. And that ended the
round 2. Fight!
Oh my god! Fierce into critical art!
Yeah. So that was actually a whiff punish. With the critical arts buffered.
Might as well use all that meter now, build it back up as the match goes on. That's a pretty commanding showing from the Super James. Eric up next.
Nikali wins.
By the way, Eric had a pretty impressive showing in the earlier round.
Yeah.
As Paolo mentioned earlier, he's gotten fundamentally stronger than the last time I actually saw him in action.
Alright, so we've seen this match before.
We got Super James versus Eric.
Round one. Fight!
There you go! That's what won him the previous match. That parry. I think so far with the Nikali players, no one was really able to challenge, let's say, it's cancelled the move that stomp attack. It's one of the first moves that I've seen that can actually challenge and stomp attack.
And when Eric's parries are on point, they are on point. He triggers on, but James takes the round.
Just one jump in.
Round two. Fight.
James, one bar away from super.
For some reason. That big of DP always works.
Jump in, stop, doesn't quite make it. Here comes the super. Still a lot of time to build up another bar or two for EX moves.
There you go. There goes a nice jump in.
Nice chunk of damage right there from Eric. Still has a chance to take this round.
Let's see what's gonna set up B. Okay, so V-Trigger's gonna run out.
Tense situation. Nice overhead from Eric. James,
so I got a chance.
All right, Justin, see you on the other side.
Nikali all right,
so Justin's
wins.
Up next. Who's actually joining me here, or do I have to do this all alone now? All right, it's James versus Justin. A Nikali versus Kairi in the matchup. And Paolo is joining me once again.
I hear we're gonna have a James OCP right now.
Let's see.
Let's see if Justin can stop the onslaught of James.
Of course, Justin's first showing at tonight's team battle.
James is actually one of the most fearsome Nikalis we have in the Philippines.
Round one.
Of course, James, with the level of aggression that he uses for his Nikali, once he gets going, he gets going.
Nice footsies from Justin.
V reversal. James, exchange of V reversals. Not much of a follow-up there from Justin, but still getting the damage anyway. EX stun. Oh, James. Standing fierce, no follow-up there.
There you go. Takes the round nonetheless. Let's see if James can make the adjustment. If Justin round takes two. Out James, this is going to be a really, really big plus for Clayton because he, James is actually one of the big hitters of Team FGS. Right, speed setup. Nice yodel there for Justin.
EX for Senha and the crush counter.
Oh, nice!
That's the crush counter! EX launcher. Nice bit of damage right there. V-Trigger is ready for Justin this early in the round.
And he still has a lot of life.
That's a good life lead. EX stomp for James.
That life lead is slowly whittling away. Here comes the V trigger. All right, here we go. Punish.
Almost get me with a Finchoy mix-ups.
V trigger is now active from James.
Here comes the scary part from Nicali. Justin should just sit this out and just gets the throw. That was almost it.
What a little tick.
Justin can take this. Around.
Here comes the throw.
KO.
Nice. Nice dash in, and I do believe that was extending in forward into low meaty punch.
Nice overhead from James. Nice confirm there from Justin.
Oh! Nice! Not quite a crush counter, but still we are taking that.
Oh yes, and all Justin right. has full meter.
Justin
right now.
Is sitting on a full critical meter.
It's gonna be a really
almost
big
at the same amount of life. Spoke too soon. Chains on the throw. V reversal from James.
Nice empty jump there. Okay, he got a Yoshi mix up.
A reset into a command grab. James Factor in action right there. Still, I wouldn't count out Justin. That was a pretty impressive first round. James just, of course, turned it around later on in the game. And who do we have up next?
We have Zambi, another Korean player.
Nicali Suyu, Kareem Kanji.
Zambi with a look of focus right now.
Round one. Fight.
Let's see, here we go. Starting out in the neutral. Oh, using a standing medium kick here in the
Our two players keeping the action pretty close to each other.
Zambi with a full stick of V-meter right now.
Zambi's V-trigger is active, not getting a lot of use out of it. Nice move to super once again. And
here comes the super! Aqua resets.
Are we gonna hear a current laugh? Not quite.
Round two.
But fight. Here we go. Beware that James has equal stick and water as well. Nice overhead.
And I'm pretty sure he will use it. Well, for an EX stomp.
And here we go. What's the setup afterwards?
Here reversal for James. V-trigger ready to go for Zambi. But James gets the throw anyway.
Final round. Fight.
Which is meter right there. Well, Zambi gets momentum.
Zambi pretty good with his hit confirms, you gotta admit that. Close to stun, nope. James getting the throw.
Was actually very close to stun there.
And here comes V-trigger once again. James, of course, rushing up. That series of dashes can be pretty scary. Especially in a high-pressure situation like this. Nice hit confirm. Resenha gets blocked. Oh no, didn't get the end here!
Here
comes the critical art. Is this gonna kill? Not quite.
There you go.
should have done the DP. You should have DP.
Nikali wins.
James getting a throw in. Pretty close one from Zambi.
15th win for player one.
And who do we have up next for Team PBE?
So we have Odie from Kabu Dojin.
I'm gonna use Birdie probably.
Nikali. Birdie.
I need something after this.
There we go.
Round one. Fight.
Wake up DP once again.
Ops for the instant overhead over there. Nice empty jump from James.
And we have stun.
Wakes up for the throw.
Sizable chunk of damage from that command grab. But here comes B trigger.
Of course.
There you go.
Should have gone for that.
Round two. Fight.
Nice beaties from James. That traded.
At this rate, he's going to make short work of this birdie.
I like that how that's done. Nice instant overhead from James.
James on a raid of terror right now. All right, how many players does PBE have left?
Player one has a 5-win streak.
So everyone's at a game apiece. Both teams with 1 point each. So earlier on, we might have said that it could be a captain's battle. So it's a FGS boss or FGS JV versus PBE boss. Players and TOs are discussing that among themselves. So are they coming to an agreement yet? Not quite. Have no idea what's going on.
So we're gonna have a little debate about whether we're gonna go for another last set of a first and 10 or a captain's match. We're debating right now. Let's see what they decide on.
Well, for those of you wondering what time it is now 11 o'clock.
Well, actually, that's the official closing time of playbook. But let's see what boss has to say. I think the final say goes to PBE boss.
All right, we are. There's a bit of time constraints here, but let's see how this is getting settled.
Oh, it's gonna be a captain's match. It's gonna be PBE boss versus. Oh wait, let's see.
So who's it gonna be? Do we have enough time for one more set?
Let's see. Oh, it's gonna be captain's match.
Okay. Right,
so it's gonna be race to three. Here's the decision. It's gonna be
captain's match. Best out of five.
Oh yes, yeah. All right. Simulate a grand final match between the two.
All right, it's on.
All right, here we go. It's gonna be Balrog versus Guile, probably. We're gonna go down to the wire right now. Because I think they made this decision based out of last time when it actually went down to a cabinets match. I think it was between BB Ray versus Bucky.
There goes the belt.
Okay, fine.
And Justin is joining me on commentary.
So it's gonna be my boss here at Playbook versus the boss. Oh, there we go.
Guile. Come on!
And fight.
Round one. Fight.
All right, so we are finally underway with the captain's match.
Yeah. So as agreed upon, since it's 1-1 versus Playbook and
a gentleman's agreement. And I totally did not expect FPS JB to go with Bison.
I haven't seen him play this character before, so.
Maybe he's got a little bit of a bit more breathing room because this is a best.
Probably because this match is actually in favor, I would say in favor of Bison. This is probably the reason why JB picked this one, because it has very a lot of tools to get near Guile, even with the projection.
Of course, he got his B skill. Nice slide right there.
Oh, look at that.
Nice dump, double reverse. The reversal for PBE Boss.
So Boss Richard here really making good moves.
He triggered
the reversal. Okay, that was a double teleport. I don't know what's going on there.
Nice side switch into a throw.
Oh, nice.
EX flash kick.
No amount of teleport can escape the EX. The flash kick. So again, this is race to what?
This is a race to three.
Okay, race to three.
Or a best out of five.
Or the captain's final match. Okay, a lot riding here for both the bosses.
You got
from each team.
You got that belt right there, which looks pretty darn sweet. And of course, bragging rights. Until the next team battle happens.
Yeah. Because the way I expect this, it's gonna be another match between Pergola and Circuit at the end of, let's say, September. And then another. It's gonna be again in October when FGS gets a chance to fight against a favorite team. So yeah, 2 months different.
Round one. Fight.
Okay, going back to his original character. Okay, so JB, as we know, has always been a backup since Street Fighter 4 days.
Crush counter into down forward roundhouse. Nice rally right there from GSJB. Pretty sweet air throw right there from PBE Boss.
Okay. It's very difficult.
Oh! Going right
I haven't seen that
boom.
Before. Nice try to approach JB. Yeah, that was like two Sonic moves that he bypassed.
Round two. Fight.
I don't know what was the command grab for that. Input for that.
jumping right there.
Oh, nice. So Buster's doing a really good job at keeping JV out. But nice tap there. JV. Apparently, that, I don't know how much armor that has.
What?
I haven't seen that.
Armoring his way.
Even against a flash kick. Even against a flash kick, apparently that's really hard.
Heck, we were both speechless right there.
Like, I didn't know some of these moves. I haven't seen them before.
Okay, if there was a stream of our faces at that very moment, both our jaws were just like.
Yeah, I was thinking of something nice to say, but I just couldn't think of something to explain what just happened. But Boss Richard now up 2-0.
Up by 2, this is a best out of 5 series.
Yeah, so yeah, Boss basically, Boss needs all the
Dream of Destiny.
It's one game away.
Needs to win all 3 games. No, successively.
Come on!
Now going for Nekali.
Nekali.
Okay, so let's use all 3 characters now at this disposal. Hopefully, just to get the game against Boss Richard's Kyle. But Sir Richard, defense is awesome as well for Sir Richard.
And as
very difficult for.
As we've seen before, you can be down by.
Round 1.
You can be down by a couple of games.
Fight.
But once you get your momentum going, there is always going to be some hope for you to take the set.
I agree.
I mean, we saw that happen with this year's NBA Finals. In any situation.
I agree.
And I'm
not done until it's done.
Yeah,
so.
I'm not even that much of a basketball fan, but I am aware of what happened this year.
Oh! The thing about Guile, though, is he needs to keep a certain life for him to get comfortable. He's not really one of those characters that can make a huge comeback. Because he's more of a zoning character. But Nekali, on the other hand, has a huge potential for him.
And the burst damage is nuts on Nekali, especially a V-trigger and a jab. Take the round. PBE Boss now on match point.
Match.
And team battle point, so to speak. Of course, BBE Boss covering his approach with a 2-hit projectile and the knee bazooka
on the other side. Okay, goes wake up flash kick, why not?
Oh, comes the Sonic Hurricane!
All right, Boss Richard showing us some of the skills here. Oh, nice jump there, but that was a very safe Sonic move there. Okay. So, JV needs to make a comeback now.
The trigger is active.
Wow. That was very awesome.
Flipped just a little bit by the EXDP. And the EX Sonic Boom takes it. Congratulations!
Congratulations to Richard. And of course, playbook for retaining the bell. Okay, nice effort there.
Also, impressive showing from Team FGS.
So like, okay, congratulations to Team Playbook for retaining the Dominion Battle Crew belt. But thank you to Fairview for coming all the way here to play with us. Great job, guys. Thank you.
Yeah, don't count them out. They are a force to be reckoned with.
They're surely going to think of a new strategy when they come back here.